Hi everyone. Welcome back to Novel Idea. My name is Dia. Today I have the quarter year crisis tag. I don't think it's much of a crisis, but quarter year crisis tag, and we're just going to be going over some statistics for the year so far. Today's tea is Bengal Spice by Celestial Seasonings. This is an oldie but a goodie. Ingredients are, if you don't know, because like I said, oldie but goodie, cinnamon, roasted chicory, roasted carob, natural spices, vanilla, ginger, cardamom, black pepper, cloves, nutmeg. It's delicious. It's one of my all-time favorites. Mine right now is very hot. All right, so I'm gonna be looking down at my computer for the questions, and then I will try to include something on the screen so that you can see the graphs and statistics for yourselves. Okay, so first question is, how many books have you read so far? And I'm including April in this just because I didn't get this made right at the end of March. So far, StoryGraph says that I have read 75 books and 26,421 pages. May have read like a few more than that that I haven't logged in StoryGraph yet, but if I have, they've been really tiny ones. So. And then the second question is, have you already found a book that you think might be a favorite this year? And if not, what has your favorite book, or if you've not found your favorite book, what have you read that wasn't quite five stars? So I am currently reading this book, Willa Cather's Collected Stories. And in here is one of the first stories that I have read that has been five stars. Still reading the stories in there, but one of those stories, Neighbor Rosicky, has a strong contention of being one of my favorite things that I have read this year. So all of the other books so far this year have been rereads. And so I'm not counting those. So nearly five stars, we have The Vicar of Wakefield by Oliver Goldsmith. Was so good. I just loved it. It was only the ending that kept it from being a five-star read for me. Then I also have Augustus by John Williams that I read at the very beginning of the year. Absolutely loved it. It has some things in it that are typical to Roman history that just keep it from being five stars for me. But the writing and the well-rounded picture, the feel that you're not reading a novel rather than a history book, just all kinds of things about it that I absolutely loved. It was just the fact that it had some content in it that kept it from being a five-star read for me. And then Bicentennial Man by Isaac Asimov is another one, a short story or a novella. And it was absolutely wonderful. The only thing that kept that from being five stars was that it was too short. I wanted a little bit more, and I wanted a little more like background. There's a couple of little time jumps in it, and I wish that we wouldn't have had the total time jump, maybe smaller time jumps leading up to the one where we end up. So Those were the, I'm nitpicky. I don't give out 5 stars easily. I usually do my books on a 0 to 100% for myself. And then it says any 1-star books. So I'm gonna jump over to my story graph, go down. I have a 1.5-star, and that was The Villa by Rachel Hawkins. I read this for We Love Jenny, and it just did not, it didn't do anything for me. I wasn't interested in the storyline. I wasn't interested in the character. Did not like the content. So all of those things combined. Question number 4 is your most read genre. So far, I think that that is fantasy. And next is classics and then mystery. I read a lot of middle grade this year. So that one will drop considerably as the year goes on. But in this first quarter, middle grade comes in at 4th place. But fantasy, by far, the most read. Which is odd because I don't feel like I've read that much fantasy, but maybe they're including, no, they have a separate one for science fiction. I feel like I've read quite a bit of science fiction fantasy. So fantasy with a sci-fi bent might be a better way to put it. Okay, let's move on. A book that surprised you. Well, Neighbor Rosicky really surprised me. That's not a book, but I would say that one of the biggest surprises was definitely Vicar of Wakefield. And that was a good surprise. If I were to go for a negative surprise, it would be A Realm of One's Own by Emma Southen. I had just read Augustus and I read I, Claudius, both of which I really enjoyed. And so I was continuing on and I was doing A Realm of One's Own because it's written by a woman about women. And I expected to really like this book, and it was so irreverent and just full of profanity, and I just didn't like it. So that one surprised me in a negative way. A book that came out this year that you want to read but you have not. I'm not much for reading books the minute that they are released. So, T. Kingfisher does have a new release that is What Feasts at Night, which is the same main character that is in What Moves the Dead. And I don't know that I'm excited to read. One of the things that I loved about What Moves the Dead is that it was based on a story that I already know and love. And so that was the reason why I picked it up to read it. So there's a new book out by an author that I've not read from. Her name is Eliza Chan, and it is kind of East Asian folklore. It's called Fathom Folk, and it says, gloriously imaginative, inspired by East Asian mythology, ocean folk tales, and is a novel of magic, rebellion, and change. So that one I'm interested in. And then also, I wouldn't mind picking up Robert Jackson Bennett's newest release, which is The Tainted Cup. I really liked Foundry Side. I did not like City of Stairs and all of those, but I did like Foundry Side. So I wouldn't mind picking up the Tainted Cup and seeing how I like that one. So there's my answers for that. Number 7, one goal you made that you are succeeding at. So I didn't really make a whole lot of goals. One goal that I kind of unspoken to myself was that I wanted to read more of what I own that's on my shelf. I only have one shelf that has a TBR on it. Everything else on my shelves I've read. And so I have one shelf that has probably about maybe 50 books on it, maybe. And I really wanted to read as many of those this year as I could. And I think I'm doing fairly well. I keep taking books off of it, so that's a good thing. And then I really wanted to do more interactive BookTuber things where I was getting to sit and chat with other BookTubers or play games with other BookTubers or do read-alongs and that kind of stuff. And I have gotten to do 2 of those so far this year, and then I have also got a couple that are coming up, and then more on the horizon for later on this year. So I think that that goal is going really well also. I have some series that I am trying to finish up. Mostly I'm waiting on my library for the books that I still need. In the Darkwater Legacy, and my library doesn't have that book yet. And I want to read Sandsea, the second book in the Sandsea trilogy by Chelsea Abdullah. And my library doesn't have that yet. And I want to read Discworld, and my library doesn't have a single one of Terry Pratchett's books. And then I would love to read more in the Combat Codes series by Alexander Darwin. I don't know that the third book is out yet. I did finish up the Green Writers series. And then I also am waiting on the third book in the Sword and Fire trilogy. I'm waiting on the second book in the Celestial Ancestors duology by Holmberg. The Sword and Fire trilogy is by Melissa Caruso. Then I DNF'd the Keeper series, second book, and just decided I didn't want to do more. I DNF'd A Course of Dragons because it just was not clicking with me. I may pick it up again at some other time, but I DNF'd it for right now. DNF'd Divine Cities, which is City of Stairs by Robert Jackson Bennett, and I just was not getting along with it. Dandelion Dynasty, I am still trying to get through the first book in that series. And it is just, Grace of Kings is what it's called. It's just not something that I'm excited to pick up, and so it makes it hard for me to do it. And I just need to buckle down and do it. So those are the series. I am also reading the third book in the Rhaera Chronicles. I think it's going well. It's just a matter of getting hold of the next book in whatever series I would like to read. And then one goal that I need to focus on, and I would say that for me that would be getting things written down in my commonplace book. So I keep a commonplace book. I just don't keep it as I'm going, and I need to do better at that. So I think that's probably the goal that I really need to focus on. And then some new to me books, booktubers, bookstagrammers, booktokers that I could recommend. I think I've mentioned some of these before, but Hannah at Piles of Books is one that I thoroughly enjoy. She is a homeschool mama. She reads a lot of classics and also a lot of nonfiction. I'm really glad she started a channel. I really enjoyed her. Another one that I've really enjoyed recently is Smitten or Smitty N. And she is so thoughtful about what she posts, and I just really enjoy listening to her. Okay, so that's all the questions. And I just want to thank you for being here for the first quarter of the year so far. I will be back with a video about my favorite nonfiction books, or some of my favorite nonfiction books. And I had several of you ask for that, so I will be back with that, but didn't want to do that not being at home. Thanks for being here today. I will see you again very soon. Like if you liked it. Subscribe if you want to.